you, and the others are down here, laying down tires and things to move into a better position.
Bill went very wide as he possibly could, and missed it by about, it looked as though he was going to miss it by about 2 feet, but he only missed it in the end by about a foot.
Yeah, but most of the, I mean, not even always, I mean what you see on TV, but most of the refugee ships you see don't quite look as luxurious as that.
Must be a few rocks out there, he's coming in pretty slowly.
But he was tracing the footsteps of the John Airy, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So he stopped in at all the nice places for fishing, like Port Lincoln and Smoky Bay, Spooky Bay, Fowler's Bay, all of those.
Mm-hmm.
Tried to get down to Israelite Bay and couldn't, but he got to West Bay. And they were all bitterly disappointed because they'd powdered all their stuff and powdered their boats and hadn't caught any reasonable fish.
Came flying along here, lost the right track, got on the ledge and then came up here. This is called an excellent camping spot.
Going past.
Loyalty Beach Caravan Park. Sunday rest day. It's also washing day. This is Al's view of the beach. There he goes, he's going down the tree with a dead friend.
That's unbelievable. Phil's calling that about 2 inches.
Thank you. Secured anchor.
Thank you.
Did you get him? See this, you just look through this and press photo.
And 12 Betty bombers above Horn Island. Now Lieutenant House is 18, shoots down his first zero.
Yep. Sorry there's no door there for you.
He actually gets photographed on the plane. He smiles, I swear. Oh, I see.
Which is not a problem, but I assume that whilst they're eating, we're...
Large onto a truck, hand rolled off the truck into a place like this. Now they did not put the fuel all into one big spot on the island, or your fuel reserves. And
whoops, I got you,
you
on
that?
Yeah.
Fair. I know it gets hot, it does get hot, but it's a dry heat. It's a dry heat. Are we all here?
Yep.
You're right? Oh, all right. Down here, officers only. If you were an enlisted fellow and you were down here, you were on charges.
That means electric drill.
Yeah, that's an old one.
That's probably to fill out the identification.
Could be.
Yeah.
Pounds as well. Now the daisy cutter was for people. When it lands on the ground, it doesn't go up in the air. Now the Americans love this stuff. It was stronger than their beer.
Christianity by the missionaries. But here, in Torres Strait,
The islanders have their own special way of doing money and other decorative things, and with an Orthodox Christian ritual in which the deceased is returned to his maker.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Their native home.
The warrior spirit that the Torres Strait Islanders are well known for now has a new focus. Today, they play a fast and furious. Some of the islanders have brought their flair for rugby to the Queen.
Australia, Jamaica, and Portugal, Venezuela,
and lots of wind.
I said to Helen, we've got to do that. We haven't allowed enough light on now. I don't know how I'd afford it.
This is a typical Bamaga side street. Half housing, half industrial. We just stopped here for lunch. I don't know what this shed is, looks pretty hot. Here's the local BP service station, closed. And I think this is a power plant for Bamaga. Heading past Lockerbie, going through the Lockerbie scrub, rainforest going up to the Cape. And Terry's behind us. This near our bush camp at Pachinka. The northernmost camp spot in Australia. Little scrub turkey. Just planning what sort of cakes and champagnes to take up to the cape. There's a camp of 30 or 40 school kids who are here for 4 or 5 weeks. One class every couple of days, I think, playing games, and we're in the middle of the grommets. I'm just being bitten by a green ant. People camped just beside us in Germany. We're just here for one night. This is a German campsite next to us. And it's one of the school tents. It's been very windy. This was a tight bit of maneuvering to camp in here. The sun's starting to set, getting a bit dark. The edge of the rainforest, up to the top end of the boardwalk. At the end of the boardwalk, Mary's still chatting to these tourists. They keep panning around on the edge of the forest, looking southwest and west down back towards Thursday Island, Loyalty Beach, where we camp, probably 30-40k south. I think the sun's gone out for several minutes, so we're going to walk along past the crocs and the mangrove to the point near the mangroves. Some of the rocks for Jane and Larry climbing up to the Cape. Here come the crowds. All the kids running up. G'day. You going up to the top, are you?
Yeah.
You been there before?
Yeah.
Many times?
Yeah.
The other, one of the other kids said he'd been there before. So why are you going again?
I'm going for fishing.
Oh, are you? Right.
Can I have a look?
Yeah. Just near a cairn here. The approach. The lighthouse over there. There's the track going down to the tip. A little island off from the tip.
Yeah, there are actually two islands.
Yeah. Right. Yep.
Yeah, that's
1600th of a second with wind cut turned off. Here's the meeting of the oceans. Quite a bit of turbulence down here. There's a boat picking up people from Pachinko Resort. Back up the ridge here. Thank you.
26 suffers of.
On the cape. Just come down a little creek crossing. Just come up a very rough little gully and stop to watch the trailer come up, and we see this. That's a bit of track, a bit of twisting, pretty easy.
Ich glaube, ihr wollt auch komplett sehr schwarz wie ein Nägel.
Don't have to worry, we're sitting on the beach at Cape York.
Yeah, that's all yours. I'm taking it off to you when we get on the bus. I will take it off to you.
This is where we had dinner last night, and again tonight. Punsand Bay, the loos and showers alternating, even double showers. What was it? 13,000 year old
rainforest,
the bits of wood in it. There's the bits of wood and the rest of it's on its way to becoming oil.
See, it just breaks off. It's quite crumbly.
Soft.
Yeah, it's not at all fossilised or anything. It's not hardened even. It's quite soft and breaking.
Looks like a fossil leaf, but it's probably just stained from the black. He's like a penny size, isn't it?
Well, it's like that. You see, I think that one's a dead one.
All right.
And that one's a very big dead one.
Yeah.
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 our morning view from our tent, like camping at caves. Some of the old fuel dumps from World War II, just beside the road, coming from Punsand Bay.
There's 1.5, not 1.5.
It's covered with still water.
This is a Jardine Holland homestead, an old sawmill we just come across in the bush. And Ladadinya Creek.
photo. Oh, what if I can just put it out of the way? Oh, I bet you what this is like through the way.
I've got it set to macro zoomed out, so it'll go 48:9, but when you get up there to digital, you can get it in one thing.
I don't think I'd like to live in this forest. It's a nice place to do it.
No,
those bitey things are probably fine.
Lots and lots of parasites.
Thank you.
part of the burnout area on the way into the lagoon, where we hope to see some jabiroos or something. And we might even see some the odd pig. Lots of areas where the pigs have been rooting.
So should we turn around too, or should we keep going in the same direction?
This is the way we drove in, looking for the lagoon, which is back the other way towards the ocean. This is a dry lagoon. The ocean's on the left.
Like their bird noises coming out.